How's it going, guys? In this video, we're going to take a look at what's new in iOS 14 Beta 4. Check it out. So right off the bat, let me just say that what you're going to find in Beta 4 are subtle changes in features for the most part. And that's demonstrated here within the weather app. So if you look closely, you're going to notice that the icons that illustrate what the weather conditions will be like on various days, those have been modified slightly. So for instance, on Beta 4, the lightning bolt for the thunderstorm icon is actually behind the cloud instead of in front of the cloud like on Beta 3. And you get a similar change on the partly sunny glyph as well. So like I said, very subtle. Now another change is going to be found within the settings app. If you scroll down, you're going to notice exposure notifications now has its own dedicated panel right at the root of the settings app. Here's Beta 3 on the left side, and you don't see any sort of exposure notifications panel there. So that is brand new in Beta 4. Now, you're not going to see anything here on my screen because I don't have any sort of public health authority application that actually takes advantage of the exposure notification API. So still waiting on that. Once that appears, you'll be able to fool with that settings panel a little bit. Now, here is another change within the music app. You're going to notice that the little icon at the top upper right-hand corner to download all songs in an album, that has been modified just slightly. Now you see a little circle outline around it. Again, like I said, very subtle changes here. But when you tap that to download, you're also going to notice another change that occurs once the download of the entire album is completed. So you're going to see a brand new icon there that denotes here in just a second. Give it a sec. There we go. So you see the little checkmark icon that denotes that all the songs in that album have been downloaded. If you tap that, you get options for removing songs and deleting the album from your library. Now on Beta 3, you're going to notice that that's a little bit different. So instead of that low-key checkmark icon, you get a full text that says downloaded with the checkmark next to that on previous betas and previous versions of iOS. So I actually prefer how it looks here on iOS 14 Beta 4. And if you scroll down, you could still see those icons at the top. Now, here is another feature. This is actually really cool. So when you go in to edit a widget on your home screen, you're going to notice here on Beta 3, the background just sort of blurs out, right? But on Beta 4, when you edit a widget, the background blurs out, but it also is tinted to represent the color of the widget that you're modifying. For instance, here, the Reminders app, I get a little blue tint on the background. It's subtle, again, but you can tell the difference here when I go to edit the Reminders app on Beta 3. I don't know if you could see that, but it's a blue tint. Just take my word for it. You'll be able to see it better when I edit the Notes app here. So I'm going to long press edit widget. And you can see the yellow tint that kind of sticks out like a sore thumb. So that's a neat little addition here in Beta 4. And then lastly, we get, yes, indeed, the TV app widget, something we've been waiting for since the initial beta, because this was something actually previewed at WWDC. It hasn't actually appeared on our phones until now in Beta 4. And this basically gives you up next access right there on your home screen, similar to what you find on the Apple TV interface. You can just tap that and resume right where you left off on your favorite TV shows that you were watching or movies or whatever the case may be here. So if I just tap that, it'll load up the video service associated with that particular channel. So that was all the iOS features I wanted to show you, but I'm going to switch it up a little bit. Normally, I don't encroach or bring other sort of platforms into these iOS videos, but this was so cool. I had to show you this right here on the latest Big Sur beta. So you can see I have our YouTube channel loaded up. If you haven't subscribed, go ahead and do so right now. We'll have way more videos coming up here over the next few weeks and months. But what I wanted to show you is right here. So you get in Safari 4K support on YouTube thanks to VP9 decoding baked into macOS Big Sur. Now you may be wondering, why do you care about 4K on a MacBook Air? Well, that's true. It's not a true 4K display, but it's still a higher resolution than 1080p. So you do notice benefits and you have a higher bit rate with 4K video as well. So ladies and gentlemen, that is a look at iOS 14 Beta 4 and a sneak peek at Big Sur Beta 4 as well. If you appreciated this video, leave me a thumbs up because that helps others find this video. Let me know what you guys think down below in the comments. This is Jeff with 9to5Mac.